So, you want to create your WordPress website and you want to host it by yourself. I'm sure you've got your reasons. Maybe it doesn't make sense right now to go for a paid solution, or you like to be in control of your stuff, or you are trying to learn how to do these things by yourself. Whatever the reason is, here's the tutorial for you on how to run WordPress using Docker on Raspberry Pi. You can also use this tutorial to host WordPress website on almost any other popular Linux-based distribution, or even in virtual machine. It's so simple, you wouldn't believe me. Let's count the number of steps right now. Launch your Raspberry Pi, install Docker, create or copy Docker Compose YML definition file of the WordPress site, I'll provide you with this one, and launch the WordPress container stack, and that's it. 4. 4 is the number of steps you need to take to self-host the WordPress site on Raspberry Pi. And all of the steps are so easy, anyone can do them. Little bit of information about WordPress. WordPress is the number one solution when you want to create your fully featured website. According to studies, WordPress powers 43% of all the websites on the internet and 65% of all websites that are built with various content management systems. Just think about it. Half of all the websites on the internet run on WordPress. So if you want to run your website on WordPress, you've probably made the right call. Okay, let's do this. Launch your Raspberry Pi. It should arrive with pre-installed SD card. If you don't have your Raspberry running smoothly right now, you can use this tutorial of mine to install a brand new Raspberry OS on your SD card. Next. Install Docker on your Pi. If you don't know how to do this, click on this link in the corner. It's really simple. I think it's like one command. It's something like crawl-fssl, get Docker comp and pipe it to shell. And add your user to the Docker group to be able to use it without root privileges. Sudo usermod-ag docker and your user. And relog to your Raspberry Pi. And nowadays, you can skip the second part of that tutorial about Docker Compose, as Docker integrated the Compose subcommand within itself. I need to make an update on that tutorial. It's not like it doesn't work anymore, it's just easier today. Now, create a directory in which you will store your Docker definitions. I propose you do it like me. In your home directory, create Docker WordPress directories, make their Docker WordPress, jump inside them, cd docker wordpress, and create a docker compose yml file, and inside it put the definitions of WordPress, its db and so on. I'll give you the link in the description. Let's review the file so you know what's happening here. If you don't want to change anything and want to make just a quick test run, you can jump to the next chapter of this video and skip this to save some time. A little tip here, did you know you can jump to the next or previous chapters of this video by holding the Option or Control key and pressing the right and left arrow? Yeah, you can, go and try it. I'll wait here. Okay, you're back. Let's continue. The version of this Docker Compose file is 3.9. You see, we've got three services here. VPDB, that's a WordPress database, WordPress itself, and phpMyAdmin, which you can leave commented out as you don't really need it. I included it here for you. If you ever need it, you can uncomment it, launch it, and connect to WordPress database via user-friendly web UI. Okay, in VPDB, we've got image of Maria database, which is basically good old MySQL database brought to us by guys from Linux Server IO. Big thanks to them for this fantastic image. It has some advantages over the stock MariaDB image. Volumes specify paths. The first part before the colon is the location of the bind mount on your host Raspberry Pi, where the database files will be stored. The part after the colon specifies the path inside the Docker container. Do not change the second part. Restart always means that if anything goes wrong, we want the database container to restart immediately and be up and running all the time. Container name is pretty self-explanatory. It's just a user-friendly name so you can use it to work conveniently with container. And in the environment section, we will configure a bunch of things like PUID and PGID. Well, here's the advantage over the stock MariaDB image. You can use these directives to set the ID of the user and group under which this container will run, and therefore set the owner of files created on your host system. This way the user who runs the container can manipulate the files on the host system without using sudo. If this information is kinda beyond you, you can forget it and let it set to 1000 and continue. TZ is time zone. Set it to wherever you live. MySQL root password. Make this password at least 12 characters long. MySQL database is the name of your WordPress database. I think WordPress is as good name as any. MySQL user, you can leave it on WordPress. And MySQL password, again, make this at least 12 characters strong. Okay, that's all we need to set up the WordPress database. I'll take the opportunity here to let you know you can find me on other platforms as well, like Twitter, Facebook, TikTok and Patreon. If my content brings you value, please consider subscribing to my channel here on YouTube, follow me on other social media, or if you're generous enough, support me on Patreon with as little as $1. Thank you. Now let's move on to the WordPress container itself. Depends on, says to Docker that this container depends on running VPDB so that it will start after the VPDB container is up and running. Image is set to the latest stable WordPress. Container name is again a convenient name for this container, let it be WordPress. Now volumes. Here you can see two bind mounts to the host system. The first one is SRE WordPress data. Here will be downloaded and stored all the WordPress files, configuration and so on. And again, don't change the part after the column. That's the path inside the container that needs to stay the same. And the second lane allows you to override some default WordPress configurations if you want to, just by creating a file named wordpress.ini next to your Docker Compose YML file. I use it, for example, to enable file uploads, increase the memory limit for scripts and so on. I'll give you some examples through the link in the description below the video. Next on the list are ports. These specify that the WordPress container will be available on port 8000 on your hosting Raspberry Pi and is mapped to port 80 inside the container. Again, don't change the second part. You can change the first one, but don't change the second one. Restart always is the same as the previous container. And environment, here you set dbhost, that's the name of the service up here. Database name, user and password need to match with this VPDB definition. That's all you need to set up, save the file and exit. And now all you need to do is fire up this Docker stack, so being in this Docker WordPress directory, I'll just do this, docker compose up-d. Notice I didn't put a dash between docker and compose, but space instead. That's because these are two separate things today. Compose is now a subcommand of Docker itself. The dash D means that it will start detached from the console and we can safely continue to use it or close it. You will see how the Docker images begin to download and once finished, head to the browser and open rpi.local colon 8000 or use the IP address of your Raspberry Pi with port 8000. And voila, now you have your WordPress site self-hosted and running on your Raspberry Pi. Well, that was easy, right? Let me know if this tutorial helped you. And if it did, please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel to see more tips and news you might like. What's coming in the future, you might ask? There's a lot of stuff, but a few things I can share are Cloudflare tunnels to run your website without public IP and utilizing all the good stuff Cloudflare provides. What else? We will dip our toes in ad blocking with PyHole, running your WireGuard VPN server, running Homebridge, Portainer and many other topics. If there's a topic you would like me to make a video about sooner rather than later, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, take care and bye!